Hi guys, right, I was inspired by Kevin Devine about a year ago, maybe 8 months ago, 9 months ago, to do some soap moulding, soap roses, and I finally got the moulds that he uses, or the cutters that he used in his video. I remember I tried to link it below. So I'm finally going to get a go, and I've been very inspired over the last sort of 2 days or so by Sorcery Soap here on YouTube. Go and have a look at her. I'll try and remember to link her down below as well. And she does some wonderful soap moulding. It's crazily good. On my mat here, I've got a little bit of cornflour just to like stop it all sticking. So we'll give it a go. I've got some soap here that seized on me. My wonderful son Harvey has grated it all up for me, so I don't have to use all my hands. And then I'm going to get a wedge of it and start moulding to get it to a nice malleable consistency. This soap seized on me a couple of weeks ago, actually. I probably should have done it before now, but I've had quite a rough few weeks. But it's still quite, as you can see, still good consistency for this. I think we'll try painting them with some lovely colours once they're done. Right. I'm going to mould some more of this and then I'll bring you back when I've got it ready, otherwise we'll run out of video time. I'm going to go with the bare hands because it's easier, but I'll spray with some alcohol. Nice and clean for you all. Okay. I'm going to take a little section at a time, I think. Try and get this into somewhat of a flat piece before I start rolling it with the pin. I've only got a tiny little roller. I also watched some wonderful soap moulding from Grace to You today and yesterday. I was quite impressed there. If you want to go and check their YouTube out. As thin as I can get it, possibly, I think. I use this press. And then I've got even pressure all over. Ta-da! Leave this stuff here because we can use that. And then we'll yay! Now, if I remember rightly how Kevin Devine showed us, we have to wet this area a little bit and then fold it over. That's going to be interesting whether or not it folds, but get as much of the excess cornflour off as possible because we don't want it too dry, and the cornflour does have a tendency of drying it out. Okay. So we go along here. Right. And then, apparently, oh my gosh, we fold this up and over like so. I've got some cracking along the edge here, which is sort of to be expected. I'll remould that slightly with my fingers. I'm going to come from this side, I think.
blowing out the petals just slightly. You have to be careful. Not the greatest, but I haven't practiced a lot, so it could be better. This is Easy Colours and a little bit of glycerin. This is the pink. I don't want to get it too wet, but I just want to colour up these leaves a bit. The petals a bit, sorry. Big one. Kevin showed some extra ones to help bulk out the end, so I'll give that a shot. And then we'll start folding inwards, slightly downwards. We're trying to hold it together at the same time because it wants to break apart. Oops, getting a bit off kilter. go one more round here. One last one. That's better. Slightly like paler effect, but it's pretty. Just sort of trying things out today, seeing how I feel about them all, seeing what I can create with these new tools that I've got. I thought I'd share my journey with you. Oops. Thanks for joining me today, guys.